Hey babies, it's joynavon and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. Happy new year. We made it to 2021 and I am so grateful and happy to have all of you here. So first order of business, I knew that when I did content this year, I wanted to ask you guys specifically what you wanted to see. So I asked you guys over on my Instagram what you wanted to see more of on my channel this year that you hadn't seen before, or you know, what have you. And a lot of you guys requested that I do more makeup tutorials. A lot of you guys just want me to do makeup in general, so I have absolutely no problem with that. So I knew if I was going to do makeup tutorials, the first one that I wanted to do was something 90s inspired, because first off, elephant in the room, I changed my hair. I have a braided bob for the first time in my life. And I said, okay, so I have the bob going. It's very 90s inspired, which is why I did it in the first place. And also too, I, for the majority of 2020, did my makeup very 90s inspired, because as a lot of you know, I am a 90s baby. I'm obsessed with everything 90s aesthetic. So I just naturally do my makeup like this all the time anyway now. So I knew that this was like the first thing that I wanted to do. So in this video, you are going to see me do something a little bit like supermodel glam inspired 90s vibe, the way that they used to back in the day. But I'm not using the same techniques or anything. I'm just using my same old technique from the 2000s that I learned how to do. But I'm just kind of trying to keep the same 90s vibe and aesthetic and mood to the look. So as you can see, I just finished my brows, and I usually do my brows first just so that I can get it out the way. And now I'm moving on to priming my eyes. All of the products that are used in today's video will be linked down below as usual if you guys are interested in checking them out for yourself. So I just primed my eyes with the e.l.f. Camo Concealer, and I'm just blending that out with a fluffy blending brush. And after this, I'm going to set it. So to set the concealer, I'm going to use the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. This is in the shade Honey. I absolutely love this powder. You're going to see more of it later on in the video. But setting my eyelids is what's going to help the eyeshadows blend that I'm getting ready to put on. So I want to make sure that I get enough powder on my eyes just so that the shadows can transition smoothly. So now I'm using the Chocolates Mini Palette by Juvia's Place, and I'm taking that kind of like rusty shade in there on a fluffy blending brush. So now I'm taking the Matte Vibes palette by Violet Voss, and I'm going into that red shade just to kind of warm up the transition. I felt like it wasn't like as warm as I wanted it to be, so I just added some red on top of that rusty orange to give me my desired look. Now I'm going to take the Morphe concealer. This is just like their white concealer, and I like to use this to cut my crease. Now I'm not doing a full-blown cut crease, like a perfectly chiseled cut crease for this look. A lot of 90s makeup was very soft and very matte, so by cutting my crease, this is what's going to allow me to have like a fox eye effect without having my eyeshadows bleed together, just because I'm creating another base for the lighter color to sit on. So now going back into the Matte Vibes palette, I'm taking that shade Psych, which is like a nice nude, creamy kind of a matte shade. And I'm packing this on top of my eyelid exactly where I put, you know, the concealer base down. And I'm just using the Fenty brush for this. I'm not sure which brush this is, but it's like a fluffy, flat powder brush. Now going back into the brown and the black shade in the very same palette, I'm just going to start winging my eye. So this is a pretty important step. You want to make sure that you're basically creating somewhat of a wing, but once you get your wing kind of straight, you want to take the same exact shadow and kind of draw upward towards your crease. It's kind of hard for me to explain in words, but you can see what I'm doing. So I'm just following along the natural shape of my eye. And if you have smaller eyelids than me, you can pretty much kind of fake the shape of your eye by doing the same exact thing, by just drawing it as large or as small as you want this area to be. So I'm just going back and forth between that black and brown shade, and I'm just defining the shape on both sides of my eye. And once I do that, I'm going to take another flat brush and just kind of color in the empty spots with that same tubular shade, that same nude shade of the eyeshadow, just to make sure that it's filling in the rest of the fox eye. So to soften the colors, I'm taking the shade Hairspray. And I'm taking that on a tapered fluffy brush, and I'm just going to literally buff this out because I don't want anything about this eye to be like harsh and heavy. I want everything to appear to be very, very soft. So that is like the perfect shade for me to use just to kind of diffuse the edges. So moving on to my face, I'm taking another e.l.f. Camo Concealer, and I'm just going along any areas of my face that I don't want to show through on my foundation. I want my base to be completely flawless, and I'm just going to blend all of this concealer out beforehand with a damp beauty blender. So this way, when I put my foundation on top of this, you won't be able to see any of my hyperpigmentations or acne scarring or anything like that. So now this is the part where I wish I had a proper dense powder foundation brush so that I could use the new Fenty powder foundation just to put over top of this. So if you guys have any recommendations for me, please leave them down below. But I'm going to take the Maybelline Superstay foundation as I usually would. This is in the shade 360 Mocha. And I'm going to apply this all over my face. Now, even though this is a liquid foundation, we are going to mattify the heck out of this. And I did put on a hydrating primer in the beginning of the video, so I don't have to worry about my skin getting super scaly and dry. But now I'm going to take two concealers. I'm using the Fenty Pro Filter Concealer in the shade 410 and the Stellar Beauty Concealer in the shade SO2. And I'm just going to highlight my face with them. I like using them both because the Fenty concealer is, I love it. I love the consistency of the concealer. It reminds me a lot of NARS, but I do not like how fast it dries down. So I like to use the Stellar Beauty concealer with it just a little bit, just because it is so liquidy and it allows me to move the concealer around a lot easier, especially if I let it sit for a little while. And I just feel like the two shades together give me a nice highlight without it being too bright under my eyes or on the high points of my face. So now going back into the Laura Mercier powder, I'm just going to take some of that on my damp beauty blender and set all of the areas on my face where I put the concealer. So I'm not going to bake with this, like I'm not going to let it sit for too long. I literally just put it on and kind of push it into the skin. I just like to apply this and kind of just let it sit for a second and then brush it off. So now taking the Fenty Beauty Powder Foundation in the shade 430, I'm just going to continue to set the rest of the areas of my face and kind of just marry everything together, which by the way, if you guys are interested in a review on this powder foundation, that was actually my last video before this one, so you should go check it out. I will link it down below. So now to kind of contour or bronze up my face, I'm using the Black Radiance Contour Powder Kit. And I like to just put this, you know, on my cheekbones and around my temple. And then after I'm done with that, I'm going to go back into the mini palette from Juvia's Place and take that dark brown shade and finish up the rest of my eye. I'm just going along the bottom of my lash line just to kind of add more to the smoky effect. I'm going to also drag this across the top of my eyelid just to hide my lash line so that when I put my lashes on, you can't see the band. So now taking some Fenty mascara, I'm just going to coat my lashes really quickly and then pop my lashes on. I, of course, am going to do my bottom lashes as well because I can never do my makeup without applying mascara to my bottom lashes. Now, I would not be me if I did not highlight my moles. I literally have moles all over my face. It's hereditary. I get it from my dad's side of the family. And I like to bring them out whenever I wear makeup. I don't like to just keep them hidden. I love my moles, so I just try and embrace them. So these lashes are actually by Pure Cosmetics. They came in a set, and like I said, I will be linking them down below. I didn't want to wear anything too dramatic, but I didn't want anything too natural. So this is like the perfect balance in between the two. So now I'm going to take some black lip liner, because if you know the 90s, you know, like, black lip liner with like a nude lip or just a black lipstick in general is like mandatory. That was like the whole thing. So of course, like I said, I'm taking this and lining my lips. Now that that's done, I'm just going to take the Gloss Bomb Cream by Fenty in the shade Cookie Jar and put that all over my lips. Now, the key to this, especially if you're working with black liner, before putting the gloss back into the bottle, you want to make sure that you wipe it off. That goes for like any type of lip combinations. You want to make sure that you're wiping off the brush before you put it back in the jar, just because you don't want to mess up the colors or contaminate it or, you know, just anything like that. So after I apply the gloss, I like to go back in with the liner and kind of blend the edges together, because eventually the colors are going to marry together the longer you have it on. So you don't really have to worry about blending it too much. And that is pretty much it for the look, you guys. So that is it for my first makeup tutorial of 2021. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to leave a comment down below. Subscribe to my channel for more. Let me know what you would like to see next. Like this video. Follow me on Instagram at joynavon. And until then, I will just see you guys in my next video. Bye.